So now the topic is, what is a developer tool, right? Every browser has a developer tool. And that, first of all, you should know what is a developer tool. If you open the menu, let's say I open menu here. If I open more tools, here we have the developer tool. All the browsers have developer tool, but most of the browsers, you press Ctrl Shift and I, or maybe Ctrl F12, this developer tool will be opened. At the moment, it is on the right hand side, right? But I can certainly align this window the way I want to, right? I can say, let's say I want to bring it down. So I can do this as well. Let me increase the size of entire interface, in fact, right? So this is developer tool, right? I'm closing it again and opening. I press Ctrl Shift and I. So you see, the developer tool is opened. What is a developer tool? As the name says, developer tool is meant for developers and it is available in all the browsers. So for example, let's say I open one site. Let's take the site Amazon. Now, the important point is, if you look below in the developer tool, right? Let me now increase the developer tool font size. You will see that there is a lot of coding available. The site which you have opened, which is developed using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So the site which you see, the code of this page, the current page, is visible here in the developer tool. So normally developers use this developer tool to refer what is happening. If there is any error, then that also can be rectified in the developer tool. Let's say there are few tabs here. You see these tabs, right? Let's say I click here on console. You see? I can click on sources. I can click on network. This will show me what all resources are downloaded and how much time, how many network requests are made on the server, right? For this page. And if there is any constant request happening, that also is visible here. How much memory is occupied. There are various things. As we go on, you will be understanding what all these things are. But at the moment, I just want to focus on this elements tab. And I want to show you, every browser has this interface. The developer tool is there for every browser, right? Right now I have opened Google Chrome. You may open Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Opera, whatever you want to open, that's fine. Every browser will have developer tool. Not only that, if you see here, there is something called inspect element. You see, this is an arrow. This arrow is actually a switch. If I click on this switch, it is switched on now. And now I'm moving the pointer. Let's say I just want to see, I want to click here. Or let's say I want to click here, this hello sign in. If I just click here, now that switch is off, right? So the inspect element, this arrow is called as inspect element. And when I clicked, the pointer had the capability that wherever I roll over the mouse and I click, that particular code will be available here. You see this? I have this code here. Let me click it again. I click here on inspect element and let's say I click here today's deal. So now, it is showing me the code of today's deal, that to implement this today's deal, what all HTML, CSS and other things are included for this page, right? Now see this, you have the page downloaded with source code. So you can change the CSS from this place as well, though it's not going to make any changes on the server. It is just on your machine, on this browser only, but you can do that. Just to learn more, you can see what all these guys have implemented. You like some page, then you open it and you try to decode using this developer tool. You have all the facility to do it. For example, here on this today's deal, right? If you see, if I roll over the mouse, you see it is highlighted. It says a.nav-a, right? So there is something getting applied. Not only that, the related CSS is also applied. If I cancel, you see there is some change happening. This is the CSS section, the styles, right, which is changing. I can change the padding, the scroll margin, lot of things I can change, right? And it will be changing to the related menu item. But the thing is, it is just here on your machine, on the server, you don't change anything. Very obvious, right? This is about the developer tool. This is what a developer tool is.